This month, the prophetic focus is, what wisdom is this? Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we have gathered here together this wonderful evening to hear from you. Jesus, speak to our lives in the way we would understand and comprehend. In the name of Jesus Christ, give us the grace to put your word to work. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Can I hear you? Amen?
Amen. Amen.
What wisdom is this? This was examination, or it was an amazement of the mighty works that Jesus did in Capernaum until they wonder and they say, what wisdom in this, in his own hometown. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They knew him very well. They knew the school that he went. But this kind of wisdom cannot be traced by such kind of schools. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Say, there is a higher wisdom.
There is a higher wisdom.
It is from above.
It is from above.
Glory to God. Solomon asked God for an understanding heart. He didn't ask for wisdom. He asked for an understanding heart. So it is that understanding heart that we say it is wisdom. It is what?
Wisdom.
He said, I am young. This entire nation is very fast, so great. And how can I rule this nation unless you give me an understanding heart? And after that, an encounter with God, the following day, two women came. One with a dead child. Another one, the child was alive. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the wisdom, or that understanding heart, began to operate. And from there, the entire nation of Israel were amazed by the judgment that he gave. Hallelujah. Say, I need an understanding heart.
I need an understanding heart.
To operate in wisdom, you need an understanding what? Heart. Heart. If your heart begins to understand what God is saying, then it will be very simple to operate in the wisdom of God. Amen.
Amen.
You hear people say, the Bible is like a forest. So I don't understand how they disappear in the forest, because they lack the understanding heart. They lack what?
Understanding.
Understanding heart. But when the scriptures that you read, you begin to understand them, then you begin to flow in that divine wisdom. That wisdom shall become practical in your life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The book of Proverbs, chapter number 4, verse number 7. Says, wisdom is the principal thing. Wisdom is what?
Principal thing.
Say, wisdom.
Wisdom.
Is the principal.
Is the principal.
So, it's not wisdom is a principal, is the principal. There's a difference between a and the. Amen?
Amen.
When it's a, it is, then it is. You can take it or leave it. But when it is that, you must take it. If you don't take it, you are finished. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Wisdom is the principal thing. Say, wisdom is the principal thing.
Wisdom is the principal thing.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom. And in all you are getting, get understanding. So, the root to wisdom is having an understanding heart. Having what?
Understanding
heart. So many people come to hear the word, but very few understand. And those who understand, they begin to bear fruits. 30%, 60%, and 100% according to the understanding. According to what?
The understanding.
Understanding. Some seed fell on the roadside. Some fell on the thorny ground, other stony ground, other fell in a fertile ground, but it produced according to the level of understanding. This is what? Level of understanding. Amen.
Amen.
Wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom. With all you are getting, get understanding. So, understanding is the key to flowing wisdom. Understanding is the key to flow in wisdom. Say, I must flow in wisdom. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
In the book of Isaiah, chapter 11. Isaiah 11. Say,
wisdom
is a principal thing. And with all thy getting, get understanding.
Get understanding.
Amen.
Amen.
From verse number 1 and 2, then we go to verse 3. He says, and there shall come forth a rod out of the stem of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots, and the spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the spirit of wisdom and understanding. The spirit of what?
Wisdom.
Say wisdom. And understanding.
And understanding.
So wisdom travel together with understanding. Travel together what?
Understanding.
Wisdom, they travel together with understanding. So if you lack understanding, wisdom is out of sight. If you lack understanding, wisdom cannot be seen. Until understanding come alive in you, then you will be told that you're just a simple guy, or you're just a foolish guy. Say,
every foolishness
must disappear. Amen?
Amen.
Proverbs chapter 2. Proverbs chapter 2. Let us look at verse number 5. Or if you want to understand better, let's start from verse number 1. My son, if you have received my words, say, I must receive the word of God.
I must receive the word of God.
That's number one. The number one way to access wisdom, it begins by receiving the word of God. Begin by what?
Receive.
The journey of wisdom. The journey of wisdom begins by receiving the words of God. Say, my son, if you receive my word and lay up my commandment with you, so that you decline your ear unto wisdom, because the word of God is wisdom. The word of God is wisdom. Incline my ear to my wisdom. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So that you apply your ear to unto wisdom, and apply your heart to understanding. Say, my heart
must understand.
Amen.
Amen.
So the root to wisdom, until understanding is in place, we have not begun the journey. Many people go to church and they hear a lot of things in church, but they don't understand many things. And therefore, if you tell somebody, how was the church? I tell you, it was wow. It was wonderful. What was there? You would just remember one funny joke and the shouting of that man. How he shouted in that first service. And how people were just standing and jumping. But the understanding of what was told there is far from them. Is what?
Far from them.
So we don't just come to church just to be entertained. We come to understand what God is saying. As we understand, we have started our journey of wisdom. We have done what?
Started
your journey of wisdom. Say, I hear.
I hear.
Yeah, if you cry after knowledge and lift up your voice for understanding. Wow. So, it is one thing to have knowledge, it is another thing to have what?
Understanding.
Those are two different things. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Many people understand why Jesus They know Jesus came, that is knowledge. But very few understand the purpose of the coming of Jesus. Very few. Amen?
Amen.
You hear somebody say, Jesus came so that you may enjoy life. Which in the sense, it is a truth, but it's not the full truth. Is that what? Just true, but not what? The full truth. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
In this world, there's a life of this world, and there's what we call eternal life. There's what we call what?
Eternal
life. If there's a life to be enjoyed, is eternal life. Is what?
Eternal
life. That one. So when you say life in abundance, that one, I agree. What about if you are in the Muslim country, will you enjoy life? You are born again. Like now people in China, they don't have open churches. They go underground churches. They are well? Are they enjoying life? So that's what I'm saying. It's a half-baked truth. Is that what?
Half-baked
truth. If you are going to enjoy life in abundance, it is in heaven. It is where? In heaven. No devil anywhere there. No sickness. Hello?
Amen.
No crying. Nothing. In heaven, you enjoy that life. But here or now, there are enemies. There were?
Enemies
all over you. Others, they want to put sickness when you are sleeping. Hello?
Amen.
Enemies. In this world, you find battles. After battles, you must fight. You must be a fighter. Amen.
Amen.
So the main purpose that Jesus came to this world is that to deliver me and you from the power of sin, that we may not end in hellfire. We may end where?
Hellfire.
That is the truth. And that is the complete truth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when you tell somebody in Muslim, you are saved so that you may not go to hell, you endure persecution. You endure what?
Persecution.
Because he knows if I die in sin, I'll go to hell. So it's better be persecuted and never end up in that terrible place. Amen.
Amen.
That is the main purpose why Jesus came. He came to take every sin of everyone, that we may not find ourselves in that horrible pit called hellfire. Called what?
Hellfire.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And that's why if you find people preaching, you know, Jesus wants to save you, thus that you may enjoy a good life. It's a half-truth. Even that one is a half-truth. It's a half-truth. I've seen many people are born again and they still make it to heaven, but they didn't enjoy life the way we thought. They really did what? They still made it to heaven, but they never enjoy the life that people talk about. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tell neighbor, be realistic.
Know the truth.
The real truth. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So having an understanding heart is the key to walk in wisdom. Is that what? Say is the key. To walk in divine wisdom.
To walk in divine wisdom.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So what Solomon asked that night after a great sacrifice. You know, that man sacrificed. He was in a mountain sacrificing thousands of gold. If you bring that picture now, you see how he did it. You're going to understand that sacrifice was heavy. Hello? Uchije ng'ombe moja, utoe damu, tena utoe ngozi, na matumbo weke kando, na miguu na manyama kila kitu. Inaweza chukua dakika ngapi?
Half a day.
Half a day. Ng'ombe moja? Yes, chukua half a day. Praise the Lord. Now imagine you are slaughtering how many thousands of bulls. To sacrifice to God, there were thousands. There were in the mountain. I believe the man alikesha huko. Alivaa nini? Alikesha. Kama ng'ombe za Masai zikipita hapa 100, kuna kuanga na jam. Na hiyo ni 100 tu. Umekuwa na jam hapa kikaroti. What about thousands of cattle that he sacrificed in the mountain? The man was very tired. The man was very tired. And I believe in that tiredness, he slept and God appeared and said, I can see your effort today. Today on our effort to come by you. Hallelujah. God was surprised. God was what? Such an effort. Man is slaughtering. Until God said, this is a deed, a sacrifice indeed. Amen. Amen. What do you want, Solomon? Just give me an understanding heart. That is where wisdom begins to operate. Hallelujah. May the Lord give you an understanding heart in Jesus' name.
I receive it.
May the Lord give you an understanding heart in Jesus' name.
I receive it.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Verse number 4. If you seek her as a silver and seek for her as a hidden treasures, then shall you understand the fear of the Lord and find the knowledge of God. For God gives wisdom. Out of his mouth cometh knowledge and answer. So how does God give wisdom? Verse number 6. Can we look together? What does it say? For God gives what? Wisdom. Out of his mouth comes what? Knowledge and understanding. So the way God gives wisdom, number one, he gives you knowledge. Knowledge comes number one. Then number two, you must understand that knowledge for it to become wisdom. Amen. God gives wisdom. Out of the mouth of God is knowledge. Then understanding. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say, I must go for knowledge.
I must go for knowledge.
And I must go for understanding.
I must go for understanding.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That's how God gives man wisdom. He gives him knowledge and he gives him understanding. Say, knowledge and understanding,
knowledge and understanding
from today, become my portions.
Become my portions.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So life is in crisis when somebody lacks understanding. Your life is in danger when understanding is out of place. If you don't understand what you ought to do, then you'll be stagnated. If you don't understand what steps you must take, then you cannot see good things. But you shall see good things beginning today in Jesus' name.
I receive it.
I say you shall see good things beginning today in Jesus' name.
I receive it.
Amen.
Amen.
Understanding of what God is saying will always put you above every situation and circumstances. Above what?
Every
situation and circumstances. When you understand the demands of God, no one will force you to do them. No one will be encouraging you to do them. The understanding will be the motivator. Will be what?
Motivator.
Your motivator. Your understanding. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Say, I'm a child of wisdom.
I'm a child of wisdom.
The only wise God.
The only wise God.
Shout, the only wise God.
The only wise God.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah. He's the only one, is epitome of wisdom. Epitome of wisdom. God only is full of wisdom. Full of what?
Wisdom.
So if you are a child of that God who is full of wisdom, then that knowledge and understanding will begin to give it to you in Jesus' name.
Yes.
He shall be pouring upon you in Jesus' name.
I receive it.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You know, wisdom teaches death and destruction a lesson. It teaches them a lesson. That's what? It frustrates them. It humiliates them. That's why when the devil wants to destroy you, when the wisdom of God is operating in you, you don't understand what has happened? Others will be destroyed, but you will be left. Amen.
Amen.
Others will be dying, but you will be living.
Amen.
Because of the wisdom power that is operating in your life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This Bible, you find it like this. This is a bank for wisdom. Is it what? This is a bank for wisdom. And anyone who is not born again, when you read this Bible, is in a forest. Is it?
In a forest.
And if you are not born again, when you read this book, you disappear. You don't find yourself. Hello?
Yeah.
You are lost. You are what?
Lost.
That's why you find many people don't like Bible, reading Bible. But anyone who is full of the Holy Spirit, when he begin to read the Bible, he begin to enjoy it. He begin to understand it. Begin to do what?
To understand
it. Because you are a child of the Most High God. Say, I'm a child.
I'm a child.
Of the Most High God.
Of the Most High God.
The only wise God.
The only wise God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We have established that Jesus Christ, who lives in us, is the power of God and also is the wisdom of God. Jesus, who dwells in our lives, is what? The power of God and what?
The
wisdom of God. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse number 24. And also we have established that in the book of Matthew 11, verse 19, that wisdom is justifiable to her children. So as being children of God, we are justified to carry God's wisdom. We are what?
Justified
to carry God's wisdom. So it's not blasphemy to say, I have the wisdom of God. It is the right of every child of God to have the wisdom of God operating in this life. Amen.
Amen.
As the way it is the right of every child of the devil to operate in the wisdom of Satan. So it is our right to operate in the wisdom of God as the children of the Most High God. Say, I'm a child of the Most High God.
I'm a child of the Most High God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And that's why we understand every child manifests the wisdom of their parents. Manifest what?
The wisdom of
the parent. Amen.
Amen.
So there's no one day you find a snake laughing with you. The wisdom of a snake is to bite you and put poison in your body and kill you. Hello? Yeah, so finding somebody laughing with a snake is very funny. It's very what?
Very,
very, very funny. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When we are born again, we are born of the Spirit. We have done what? Whatever is born of the flesh is what?
Flesh.
So we carry, when you are born of the flesh, you carry human wisdom. You carry what?
Human wisdom.
But the day you are born again, because you are born of the Spirit, then your spirit man has the mind of Christ. Has what?
The mind of Christ.
Mm-hmm. Whatever is born of the flesh is flesh. Whatever is born of the Spirit is spirit. So this person born of the Spirit carries the wisdom of God. This person born of the flesh carries the wisdom of man. Amen.
Amen.
That is the distinction. And that's why you find when somebody dies, he leaves the body, but the spirit continues to live forever. That's the spirit that carries the wisdom of God. It carries what?
The wisdom of God.
That's the spirit that carries the power of God. Your body cannot carry the God's power. Your body cannot carry the wisdom of God. It is so limited to do so. Amen.
Amen.
That's why everyone must be born again, because it is in the Spirit the Holy Ghost resides. It is in the Spirit, your own spirit, where the power of God resides. It is in your spirit where the wisdom of God resides. Amen.
Amen.
Say, I'm a spirit being. Say, God is a spirit.
God is a spirit.
And also I am a spirit.
Also I am a spirit.
But I live inside this body.
But I live inside this body.
Say, this body.
This body
is just my house.
It's just my house.
That protects me.
That protects me.
Against the enemy.
Against the enemy.
Yeah. The moment you come out of this body, that's the day the devil will be happy. We have to feature sana. Come, especially when you are a sinner. We have to feature sana. Sana we to make ukamata. The moment you die, the moment you do what?
Yeah.
So this body is what protects you from the enemy. This body. It's very important, this body. Hello? Some people have died today. Today, many people have died. So there are some demons celebrating. Ah, aye, mkomu najifanyanga, uja hapa. Hello? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say, I must make it to heaven.
I must make it to heaven.
By the wisdom of God.
By the wisdom of God.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When we talk about the wisdom of God, we are talking about the wisdom that literally operates in heaven. It operates where?
In heaven.
In heaven. That wisdom that operates in heaven, whereby there is peace in heaven, where there is no sickness in heaven, there is no poverty in heaven. That wisdom is what we access here on earth. The moment you are able to access that wisdom that operates in heaven, then you begin to enjoy your own heaven here on earth. You begin to enjoy what? Your own heaven here on earth, practically. Amen.
Amen.
Say, I have the mind of Christ.
I have the mind of Christ.
I have a deposit,
of
God's wisdom
in my
mind. It is my responsibility to stir up that deposit of wisdom in my mind.
Amen.
So when God has given us a sound mind, it's not a sound mind to go to sleep. Is a sound mind to work it out. Do what?
Work it out.
Say, I must work it out. One of the ways to work out this wisdom is by reasoning. Shout, reasoning.
Reasoning.
Now, let us go to the book of Isaiah chapter 1. Isaiah chapter 1. You must know how to reason if you want to understand. Because it is in reasoning that you gain understanding. You gain what?
Understanding.
Understanding. Isaiah chapter 1, verse number 18. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, verse number 18, it says, come now, let us reason together, says the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
God always calls you and me to come together and to reason together with Him. To do what?
Uh-huh.
In the beginning was what? The Word. And the Word was what?
God.
With God. And the Word is?
God.
God. So when you are bringing the Word of God in your mind and you begin to reason with that Word, you are reasoning together with God. You're doing what?
Reasoning
together with God. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you must create time to reason together with God. Say, I must create time.
To reason.
Together with God.
Though
your sins be as scarlet, they shall be as white as snow. Though they be red as crimson, they shall be as wool. If you are willing and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So it is in the platform of reasoning you get understanding and you find yourself eating the good. Eating what?
The good.
Eating the good. So, the moment you begin to reason together with God, you gain understanding. The more you understand, good things begin to happen. Amen.
Amen.
Say, I must reason together with God.
I must reason together with God.
Amen.
Amen.
These are taking issues, begin to think about them. Thinking about them. Reasoning together in scriptures. Reason together with God. If you are the one who are in this situation, Father, what would you do?
Yes.
You are reasoning together with God. Sawa ni memes, sikatai, because ni mefitenda dhambi. Lakini kama niwe nisaza Mungu wapanta fanyaje, ni toke from this mess. You are reasoning together with who? With God. You are reasoning together with God. Your mind should be active reasoning. You know, this young man, we call him prodigal son. He went for a very far country. He went where?
A very far country.
And I believe, alikuwa anasikia stories, akiwa kwa baba yake. Huku nje ni kuzuri sana. Huku kuna warembo wengi. Wewe unakaa kama umezubaa huko ndani. Amen? Huku nje kuna nini? Warembo. Huku nje tena kuna disco. Huku nje kuna vitu vizuri. Wewe umezubaa sana kwa baba yake. Siku moja nilipokuwa mkubwa akasema, ah daddy, my portion, acha ni enjoy life. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And he was given his portion. And the man went to a very far country because he was seduced by his friends. Was that what?
Seduced by his friends.
The man began to drink, sleeping around with women because he's very rich. Went from one disco to another. And I believe maybe if that young man was nowadays, he could be flying from America and say, Mapana, aje tosheka, going to China. Say, Mapana, tena India. Hello? Kukula raha. Kupa nini? I tell you, praise the Lord. If you see the heart of the people, they're so wicked. If you gave them 10 million like today, they will not even build a house. They will travel. They will go very far. The wickedness of hearts of men. Amen. Jamaa alikula raha mpaka pesa ikaisha. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And he became employed. Somebody who was a king, supposed to become a prince, became a slave. Not a slave, even worse than a slave. He began to eat the food of the pig. Then, in that state, he began to engage himself with God. He began to reason. He began to use what?
Reason.
Say his mind.
His mind.
Begin to reason. That's the same. Sasa mimi nimeteseka hapa. Kweli nimekula kila kitu nimeisha. Lakini nikirudi kwa daddy, lakini siwezi rudi namna hiyo. Akawachana na daddy akasema, hata wafanyi kazi kule, wanakula vizuri hata kuniliko na mimi ni mtoto wake. Ai. Alienda kulizo. Alifanya nini?
Kulizo.
Hao wafanyi kazi mwingine yule nakumbuka hata Sara, yule akiamuka alikuwa ananyanyisha ananiamsha kwa mtoto nikienda shule. Na bado yuko huko. Anakaa maisha mzuri hata nikuliko mimi hapa. Amen. Ule mwingine na pelekeza safarasi. Huyo mwingine anafanyanga hivi. Akaanza kuangalia all those servants. Akona they are so super blessed than him. He said, Acha mimi hata niingie hiyo klasi, nisiwe mtoto wake. Niwe tu hiyo klasi tu. At least ni enjoy your life. Hallelujah. He was reasoning himself. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The moment he reasoned, understanding was coming. What was coming?
Understanding
was coming. The understanding came to him until he arose. He said, I must go to my father now. And I will say, I have sinned against you and against the other. The man walked, marched out. Alitoka kwa shida hiyo siku. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You are coming from that problem in Jesus' name. As you begin to reason with God, I see you coming out from that affliction in Jesus' name.
I receive it.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's how that man was restored. By reasoning. By what?
Reasoning.
He was restored like that. And one thing I thank about his father is because he was a super rich man. He was a what?
Super rich.
So, he was a squander, he was a kidogo. He was a nyingi kuliko hiyo. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Say, I will reason my way out.
I will reason my way out.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 As you reason together with God, I see you moving forward in Jesus' name.
I receive it.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, reasoning is all about thinking about a subject matter of concern. Thinking about what? Subject matter of concern. Kitu ambayo inakusumbua. That's the thing you begin to reason. God, if you are the one here, what would you do? And you begin to reason with him. As you are reasoning, you are getting understanding. Huh? Okay, imena kitu hapo. Because you must create time to do that. You must create time to do that. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Sometimes my wife will tell me something and I don't have the answer. So I tell her, that issue I'll talk it tomorrow. Why? Because I must go and reasoning out. I must go and do what?
Reasoning.
I sit down and begin to reason. To see what's the right way. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because if I don't have the answer, then I need time to reason, to get the understanding. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Sometimes you may ask yourself, or we can say, we understand that every whatever is written in this Bible is written for man. It's not true. This Bible is not written for God. It's written for who?
For man.
For man. So, whatever is written in this Bible is for our own benefit. The Bible is not written for the benefit of God. It is written for what?
For our benefit.
Say, for my benefit.
For my benefit.
Mm-hmm. So sometimes you may ask yourself, why did God say, after salvation I must serve Him? Why should I serve God? And those are questions and reasons someone needs to reason. Why must I serve God? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because you don't need anyone to encourage you to win souls for Jesus. It should be something that you have understanding about it. You don't need anyone to encourage you that I need to pray. Understanding should be inside of you. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Every commandment of Scripture is for our understanding. Not for understanding, it's for our benefit, sorry. It's for what?
Benefits.
Every commandment of Scripture is for my benefit. Say it's for my benefit.
Say it's for my benefit.
Amen.
Amen.
No scripture is directly benefiting God. No scripture in this Bible benefits God. It only benefits me and you. Whatever is written here is for me and you. And I see those benefits, I'll not be encouraged to obey that word. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's see about the serving God. Serving God. Because you need to reason your way out so that your service to God must be out of joy, delight. Amen.
Amen.
Out of what? Joy and delight. Many people serve God with murmuring and complaining in their hearts. Physically, they are serving God. But inwardly, they are complaining. Hello?
Amen.
Hello?
Amen.
Outwardly, they are doing what? They are serving God, but inwardly there is no joy, no excitement, no zeal. But they are still serving God. Hello?
Amen.
Say, I must serve God.
I must serve
God. With understanding.
With understanding.
Yeah. If you don't serve God with understanding, you'll be complaining all through. Amen.
Amen.
Wisdom, I say, begins with understanding. It begins with what? Now, Proverbs, not Proverbs, Job 36, verse 11. Job 36, verse number 11. If they obey and serve Him, they shall spend their days in prosperity and their years in pleasure. So that means, if you take that scripture and begin to reason with God, begin to do what?
Reason with God.
To reason with God. You're telling God, God, okay, you're telling me if I obey you and I serve you. So it is my days in prosperity, okay? Hello?
Amen.
It is me, oh, not a... we are reasoning together with God. So if I obey you and I serve you, my days will be prosperity, okay? Hello? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
You begin to see the benefits. You begin to see what?
Benefits.
Hey, those benefits. And my days in pleasures. My years in pleasures, days in prosperity. So you begin to think and you begin to see the benefits which are connected to serving God. Which are what? Connected to serving God. So when you come to church, or whenever you, anytime you come, you don't come dragging your feet. You come exactly like David. David said, I was glad when they said to me, let us go to the house of God. He was super excited. He was what?
Super excited.
That was David. He was the king, and yet very excited to go to church. Hello?
Amen.
Hello?
Amen.
Because he had understanding. He had what?
Understanding.
Understanding. Understanding. I remember those days we used to go to church very far. Don't answer a warm up. And church it's but by 6 we may talk at home. Warm up. In a church. Because it's very far. It's very far?
Very far.
Very, very far. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Say, I must reason my way out.
I must reason my way out.
Amen.
Amen.
Now let's see another scripture in the book of Exodus chapter 23. Exodus 23. Nimefika. Okay, 23. It says, verse number 25. 23, 25. And you shall serve the Lord your God, and you bless your bread and what?
Water.
Does God need the bread?
Yes.
God?
No.
Does he need the bread?
No, he doesn't.
Musha kutana mungu impatie mkate. God doesn't need bread. Who needs bread?
It's me.
It's me. Hello?
Amen.
Say, God does not need the bread.
God does not need.
It is me.
It is me.
Who need the bread? Yeah, you need that food, daily food. You need the water to drink, but not God. Amen.
Amen.
Where he is seated, the river of life flows from his throne. So he doesn't need it, so that you may partake of it. You may do what?
Partake of it.
Partake of it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we serve God because we are the one who need the bread and the water. Say, I need it.
I need it.
Shout, I need it.
I need it.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So he says, and you shall serve the Lord your God, and he shall bless with, he shall bless your bread and your water, and he will take sickness away in the midst of you. Can God be sick?
No,
never.
Never. Amen.
Amen.
So as you are reasoning, say, it is for my own benefit. I'm serving God so that my body may remain healthy all the days of my life.
Amen.
Hello?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm serving God because I will not lack what to eat. David said, when I was young and he is old, he had never seen God forsaking the righteous person. David never lacked what to eat because he served God throughout his life. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Say, I will never lack.
I will never lack.
What to eat?
What to eat?
Say, I will never lack.
I will never lack.
The water.
The water.
And the bread.
And the bread.
And my body.
And my body.
Will be free.
Will be free.
From sickness.
From sickness.
Amen.
Amen.
And then it says, and shall nothing miscarriage or be barren in the land, and the numbers of your days are fulfilled. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say, I will not die prematurely.
I will not die prematurely.
I shall serve God.
I shall serve God.
I'm not supposed to die prematurely.
I'm not supposed to die prematurely.
Amen.
Amen.
Those are things you begin to reason from scriptures. You begin to see yourself there. Amen.
Amen.
No miscarriage, either the womb or your business or your career. No miscarriage. No miscarriage. Amen.
Amen.
No barrenness in whatever you do. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So all these benefits belongs to us when we reason well. When you do what?
We reason.
Yeah, we reason well. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when we reason, we are able to access every benefit loaded in every scripture. Every what?
Scripture.
Every benefit loaded in scriptures. Hallelujah. You know, when you begin to understand the scriptures and you begin to undo the scriptures, there is the benefit which is attached to that scripture. When you do it, then that benefit God begin to add on you. When God adds it to you, no devil can remove it. No what? No devil can remove it. Amen.
Amen.
So the issue here is not the devil. The issue here is man. Is man understanding what God is saying? If he understands, he will go for it with those energy. He will do what?
Go for it.
Ukisikia, kama ni mzungu amekuja hapa nataka kwanza church, asema, kila mtu aniletee watu kumi kumi, nitakuwa nampatia 10,000 each. Ah, I tell you, people will die for, for money, they will die. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. But God does not want that one. God wants your understanding come alive. As you do it, you are doing it for Him. As you do it for Him, He acts. Because He says, seek ye first my kingdom and my righteousness. And everything you desire shall be added to you. When God adds in your life, no devil can remove it. No what?
No devil
can remove it. Amen.
Amen.
Every blessing that comes from above is a permanent blessing. Is that what?
Permanent
blessing. Glory to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I see you coming from that challenge like that prodigal son in Jesus' name. I see you coming out in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. You can know what's hold for you for tomorrow when you understand what you are doing today. Amen. You can know your future, how it is, by understanding what you are doing today. You don't need a prophet to prophesy to you. You become a great one. I don't need. When you understand what the word of God tells you, you know you are going to greatness. You know it. You don't need anyone to encourage you. Hello?
Amen.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse number 1. A scripture that I speak here every time. Amen.
Amen.
You know it. You'll be knowing it. It's not a guesswork. It is really there. Amen.
Amen.
Say no guesswork.
No guesswork.
Yeah, no guesswork anyway. It says, and it shall come to pass, if you shall hearken diligently to the voice of the Lord your God, and observe to do all his commandments, which I command you this day, that the Lord your God shall set you on high. Where?
On high.
Above all the nations of the earth. And all these blessings shall come on you and overtake you, if you shall hearken to the voice of the Lord your God. You know your tomorrow is better by engaging what God is saying today with understanding. With what?
Understanding.
With understanding. You can know what holds for you tomorrow. You know it. Amen. So you don't need one prophet who is vibrating to tell you how your tomorrow will be. I don't need. It is there in scriptures. Understand what God is saying in scriptures. And then you know your tomorrow is secure. Say, my tomorrow is secure.
My tomorrow is secure.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And that's why we should believe Matthew 6:33. Matthew 6:33 is about engaging the business of God here on earth. And also watching yourself living a righteous life. Seek ye the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Also you must be righteous. Because if you don't live a righteous life, you miss heaven. You miss what?
Heaven.
Yeah. There are many people who are engaged in kingdom, but they've forgotten the righteousness. They don't know what?
Forgotten
the righteousness. Your righteousness is your relationship between you and God. Between who?
You and God.
You and God. That is what you call. Seeking first the kingdom of God, that is, you are serving God, seeing people saved, you are praying for people, you are helping people, you are giving to people, that is seeking the kingdom. That is what? But don't forget about your life. Your life is righteousness, holiness, and truth between you and God. That one should not be forgotten. Because many people have forgotten his righteousness. Have forgotten what?
Righteousness.
But they are very busy preaching, very busy giving, very busy helping, very busy interceding, but between them and God, their own relationship, the righteousness, is not there. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we have two legs. Leg number one, kingdom. Leg number two, righteousness. Because righteousness will make the gates of heaven open for you to enter. Without righteousness, or without holiness, no man shall see God. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So as we are serving God here on earth, never forget righteousness. Never forget what?
Righteousness.
Never forget that one. Amen.
Amen.
Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And all these things that many are fighting to get to you shall be addition. You don't need to fight for them. God will be commanding them to come.
Amen.
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 And all these blessings shall show up. They shall run after you, overtake you, because they are commanded by God. They what? Commanded by God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say, I'll serve God.
With understanding.
I don't need encouragement. Yeah. So when you say tomorrow we are coming here for soul winning at 9, don't need Pasia Jivin Majoga. Sing it. And Pajetu Mazini Lale Kido Wibi Boan. Niki Furai. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Say, I must serve God.
I must serve
with understanding.
With understanding.
Yeah, with understanding. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
May your works be registered in heaven, Jesus' name.
Amen.
I said, may your works be registered in heaven, Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Now I want to show you another wisdom we need to engage as believers. I call it the wisdom of declaration. The wisdom of what?
Declaration.
Let us go to the book of Luke, chapter 21. Luke 21. Luke, what did I say?
Luke 21.
Okay, verse number 15. He says, I'll give you a mouth and wisdom. And what?
And wisdom.
Which all your adversaries shall not be able to contradict or resist. Say, this is my mouth.
This is my mouth.
It's not just eating the deli.
It's not eating for eating.
And chips.
And chips.
And chicken.
And chicken.
This mouth.
This mouth.
Is a weapon.
It is a weapon.
Before God.
Before God.
To put wisdom here. To declare it. For God to show up.
For God to show up.
Uh-huh. What you don't say, God will never confirm. What you don't say, your hand will never handle. What you fear to say, you never touch it or experience it. When I say, I cannot be sick, I'm telling God, can you confirm that word I've spoken?
Yes.
Amen. It's called wisdom. It's called what?
Wisdom.
Yeah, wisdom. When I say I refuse to be sick, God says, I hear my son. You are like me. Even me, I don't like sickness. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And then he comes, he says, the one angel, go make sure those demons of sickness far away from my son. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
But if you are the person who celebrates sickness, the way I feel in my body, even you come out here. I don't know if you came to me and said, your pain, you feel like your end, and you can see in it, you see color or something. You know?
Good.
Now, come back to India. I'll give you a mouth and wisdom. And what?
Wisdom.
When you say, when you're weak, don't say you're weak, say, I am strong. That is wisdom. That is what?
Wisdom.
Wisdom. Don't say you're weak. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Anytime you are in a situation where the devil wants to put you in a corner, you understand you need to put the wisdom of God in your mouth. You want to put what?
The wisdom of God.
Because you one funny headache at Mianza Abba, I said, Manga, in the name of that arrow of headache, back to say that in Jesus' name, I refuse to be sick. After Nasao, now I'm with Kijuangu Mekwa fresh because one angel has been sent to freshen my mind. To do what?
Freshen.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Open your mouth wide and I'll do what?
I'll feel it.
So speak and let God confirm it. Speak, let God confirm it. That is called wisdom. Called what?
Wisdom.
Wisdom. It looks foolish, but that is the power of God. Romans chapter 1, verse 16. Romans chapter 1, verse number 16. It says, "For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believes, to the Jews first and to the Greeks." Hallelujah.
Amen.
He said, the gospel,
the wisdom of God,
in my mouth. It looks so foolish, but it's the power of God. Amen. So when you wake up, you say, I cannot have accident. I'm not a child to be killed by accident. Amen. That is wisdom you are putting in your mouth. That is what?
Wisdom.
So when you enter the vehicle, you know no accident anywhere. You are going to your destiny.
Destination.
No devil will kill you. I'll give you a mouth and wisdom. Mouth and wisdom. You must understand that you are not a cockroach to be killed. You are a son of the Most High God. Protected with the angels. Protected with what?
Angels.
Yeah, you have many angels around you. So when you go tall and speaking rudely to the devil. I cannot be killed by accident. No witch can kill me. Amen.
Amen.
That is putting wisdom in your mouth. Putting what?
Wisdom
in your mouth. Harassing the devil the way you want it. Amen.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Say, as for me.
As for me.
I'll open my mouth.
Very wide.
Amen. Putting the wisdom of God in my mouth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
So, what you desire, let your mouth speak it. Let your what?
Mouth speak it.
The moment you speak problem, that is not wisdom. That's foolishness. The moment you speak what you like good health, you like prosperity, that is wisdom. That is what? Say, that is wisdom.
That is wisdom.
God saw darkness. He never sit there and begin to cry. Oh, the other is full of darkness. Oh. I begin to cry. He put wisdom in his mouth and said, let there be light. That is wisdom. And there was also light. Amen?
Amen.
He said what he desired. He said what?
What
he desired. Wisdom is putting the desire which is in line with the word of God. Which is what? In line with the word of God. Even the Bible says to be saved, you must believe in your heart and then speak it with your mouth and then you shall be saved. The same formula of how you are saved, that if you want to be saved from poverty and sickness, believe you cannot be sick and then speak it with your mouth and then you are free. Hello? Hallelujah.
Amen.
The day I begin to say I'm going to be rich, people are laughing at me because it looks so foolish inside poverty. But I say, one day I'll be driving my own car. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I was speaking rudely. I came to people are just laughing because I didn't look like it. I didn't what? So all those believers, when now they see me and say, no wonder. Amen. It is just taking this wisdom, put in my mouth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Say power.
Power
is in the power of the tongue.
It's in the power of the tongue.
Yes. Put the correct word in your tongue. You begin to correct your life. You begin to do what?
Correct your life.
To correct your life. That is wisdom. That is wisdom. People will laugh at you, but continue speaking it, and God will confirm what you are being speaking.
Amen.
Very shortly, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Shout, I hear.
I hear.
Proverbs 18, verse number 21. Then I read one scripture, and then we close. Proverbs 18, verse number 21. Because I see the time is almost over. Proverbs 18, verse number 21, it says, death and life are in the power of what? Of the tongue. And they that love it shall eat the fruit of their life. If you love to speak, you will eat what you have been speaking. You will eat what? What you have been speaking. Angalia vile unaongea. Ukiangalia ile mambo unaongeanga, hiyo ndio vitu nakulanga sasa hivi. What you love saying is what you are eating now. If you love saying sickness, that's what you are eating now. If you love to say poverty, that's what you are eating now. Amen.
Amen.
Najua hii dunia ni dunia ya mashida mingi. Hii shida si vita, itaisha baleni. Lakini hii mashida ni mingi, ni mingi. Tendea tunakula hiyo mashida. What you love talking is what you are eating. What you love talking is what you be what?
Eating.
Na mazee nimesota sana. Nimesota. Nimeangalia. Na kweli hata God says mpatia kitu. Hautawe mpatia. Hello? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say, I'll put wisdom.
I will put wisdom.
In my mouth.
In my mouth.
Against all my adversaries.
All my adversaries.
Amen.
Amen.
Don't be like Jesus. Don't be like who?
Jesus.
Jesus alifunga mdomo yake when he was going to the cross. Alifanya nini? Because of your
salvation.
Yeah. Alifunga mdomo. He said he was laying like a sheep to the slaughter. He closed his mouth because he knew if he opened his mouth, I'd end up on the cross. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
He said he gave his life for my sins. Unataka shetani akusulote? Open your mouth. Say, I must open my mouth.
I must open my mouth.
I'm not going to the cross.
I'm not going to
the cross. I'm not dying for anyone. Even you cannot die for yourself. Hello. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Jesus, that was the moment. The silence walisema. Amesikia, tuangalia hapa ndio muone. Angeenda kufungua mdomo wake, angeenda to the cross. Hebu angalia John chapter 18 verse 6. Amen.
Amen.
John chapter what?
18
verse?
Verse 6.
I'm talking about what it says. As soon then as he had said to them, I am he, they went backward. Say backward.
Backward.
And fell on the ground. Wamemshika hivi tu. Cha. I said, ni wewe? Yes, I am he. What a boom. The chibi. Nafikiri sasa angeendelea na kuongea. Angeenda msalabani kweli? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Say there is power.
There is power.
In speaking.
In speaking.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
There is what?
Power.
Power in speaking. Jesus spoke and everyone soldiers were on the ground. Kila mtu. Now let us go to the book of Isaiah. That's what the scripture I wanted to talk. Ninasema usiwe kama Yesu hapo. Ndio angalie vile alifanya in that Isaiah. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say, I'll put wisdom in my mouth.
I'll put wisdom in my mouth.
And whatever force
which
is hindering me
to see good
must give way.
Must give way.
Amen.
Amen.
Isaiah 58, verse number 7 and 8 says, did I say 58?
Yes.
53, sorry. Isaiah 53, verse 7 and 8, it says, he was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. That oppression upon you, that affliction upon you is because you are not saying anything. Because you are not what? I'm not saying anything. So Jesus, for him to go to the cross, he must literally close the mouth. He must do what?
Close the mouth.
Yeah. And he went very humble. They beat him up on gear. Oppression. That's how many believers are. Wana chap wana shetani wa wana yama. Na chap wana sikilesi ya na ata onge. Ata isi omba, ata kuomba ta onge. Amefunga mdomo. Your power
is in your mouth. Your voice where?
Is in your mouth.
Your mouth. Amen.
Amen.
They beat Jesus so much. Na mdomo alinyamaza. Kwa sababu sasa ile walimshika tu, anasema I am he. Everyone was in the ground plus the captain. Plus what?
The captain.
The captain. Na ni watu soldiers. Nenda soldiers wa Romans. Nzima soldier kama watu wanaona hapa wanakula biscuit na nini. Those were real soldiers. Amen. They were what? With muscles all over. Amen. Hallelujah. They were real soldiers. They were all down because the army of heaven that protect Jesus by them, the angels, they were the one who pushed them to the ground. They did what?
They pushed.
Sasa hakuwa nataka hawa malaika waendelee na kufanya kazi. So akanyamaza, akafunga mdomo. Mdomo. Hallelujah. You carry angels wherever you go. You carry what?
Angels,
wherever you go. So when you open your mouth, angels, you activate your angels to work. You do what?
You activate them.
Your angels to work. Amen.
Amen.
Because of time, ningeendelea na story, lakini wacha nifungie hapo. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let us be on our mouth and on our feet and ask Jesus.